This is part two of our digital painting tutorial, and we're going to look at the nose and the mouth. We're going to keep building on the same image that we had from part one, and we're still using a pressure-sensitive tablet in the same brush setup. So you're going to use a basic round brush with the opacity set to somewhere between 80 and 90%. The flow will be set to 60%, and you'll see the pixel size of the brush is actually quite small. We're also going to be using the skin texture brush again to kind of give a little bit of texture and some highlights and shadows for the pores of the skin. And you'll be using the smudge tool to blend per usual. So we're going to go into kind of the same method as we used before around the eye, where we're just going to start color blocking. And you're basically laying down color and building on top of each other to create definition of the nose. Now, if you're looking at the nose, you'll see that the light source is pretty much right dead center of her eyes in this picture, and it's a very kind of blown out light, so it's not a spotlight, but you'll see that most of the light part of the nose is right on the bridge of the nose, and as the light starts to fall away onto the sides, that's where your shadows start to appear. So you'll see where the eye comes down, you want to darken that area, and then finally where the nostrils start to come up along the left and right side is where it would start darkening again. So the curve of the nostril into the tip of the nose. The bridge and the tip of the nose will still be that lighter color, and that's a good spot to have a little bit of highlight if wanted. But we're doing the same kind of procedure. And the nose, you just want to define it just enough to get it there. It's not really a major focal point in this type of portrait. So you want to just match it up and just get it defined, but you don't want to draw so much attention away from the eyes and the mouth. Another thing that people run into is that the nostrils, you have a tendency to really darken them up. When in digital painting, you're not going to have them, you're going to have them just dark enough. You don't want to draw a lot of focus onto the nostrils. So you don't want great big black nostrils on your painting. So just enough to get a definition in there and to start building on the nose. And you'll probably come back to these things as you get color on the rest of the face to match everything together. But in the meantime, you just want to keep blocking and keep building until that depth is there and the nose is a nose. So keep going and keep blending with the smudge tool here and there, and then keep using that skin texture tool to give it, or brush to give it a little bit of definition, like pores would be, just enough to roughen it up, but not overboard. When getting into the mouth, that's kind of a different kind of area. It depends. It really goes from portrait to portrait. It depends on if your reference is wearing lipstick or if you're trying to match the color of the lips completely. You're going to use the same blocking method that you did on the nose in between the upper lip and the bottom of the nostril. So keep that in mind, and also keep in mind that the highlights are kind of in the same place. So you're going to have shadow casting down the left and right side of that area right above her lip. Also, you notice that the top lip is darker than the bottom lip in this painting, and that tends to happen quite often, because if you think of how the top lip is curved, how it curves under, it's going to be a little bit darker, and it's going to start pulling shadow into where the top lip meets the bottom lip. So you're going to have kind of a darker area where those two lips meet, and that's pretty much the darkest it's ever going to get on the mouth, unless you're drawing somebody with, it's smiling or yelling or something like that. But if it's just a smile like this, that's about as much shadow that's going to end up right there. The bottom lip, you're going to want to use, you don't want to use the blending brush as much with the smudge tool to blend, because you want those kind of cracks in the lip, for lack of a better word, to really show up. So make sure that you're defining the kind of the cracks in the bottom lip, and you'll notice that the bottom lip is a little brighter than the upper lip. So, and there's a nice kind of glossy highlight that goes across the entire bottom lip. So keep that in mind as you're painting. And for the chin, we'll get into that more on the next episode, but that's same process, color blocking, finding the shadows, and keep in mind that the bottom lip casts a shadow on your chin. It's very subtle, but it's there. So keep that in mind, keep practicing, and we'll see you at part 3.